So our GPUs, the silver bullet of CFD simulations, and our CPUs finished with. One of the constant challenges for CFD engineers is to have a good level of simulation throughput. In order to be competitive, achieving simulation results as fast as possible is a constant need. Market requirements constantly change, customer requirements constantly change, and in order to have a competitive edge, you have to be able to produce simulation results as fast as possible. On top of this, today's products are ever more complex. What this means is that you require high fidelity or multidisciplinary simulations in order to really understand your product and then drive its improvements forward. Of course, adding those layers of complexity means an increased simulation cost, where once again throughput becomes at the forefront of your mind. And of course, why do we do simulation? Well, virtual product development gives you that flexibility to run hundreds or even thousands of different design iterations to really explore the design space and find the optimal product. If we want to facilitate running those hundreds or thousands of CFD simulations, then we have to be able to get the results as fast and efficiently as possible. As a CFD software provider, we want to give you, as engineers, solutions that speed up every simulation so that you can get the same results faster, explore more designs in a given time frame, or get higher fidelity for the same cost. Effectively, we want to help reduce the turnaround time to make critical engineering decisions. One key development in this space has been allowing Simcenter STAR-CCM Plus to leverage GPU hardware. GPUs have been around for a while, so I'm often asked by CFD engineers, why are we only considering this technology now? There's been a few key developments which have really allowed this hardware to be used in the world of CFD. For example, GPU cards now have high bandwidth memory, and this allows industrial size CFD cases to be run directly on the GPU cards. Additionally, programming language flexibility has meant that large parts of Simcenter STAR-CCM Plus can be made GPU native faster. And the really exciting part of this is that the hardware itself is improving at a great pace. So being GPU ready allows us, and therefore you, to take advantage of these advancements in the technology. There's a multitude of benefits that you as a simulation engineer can enjoy using GPUs on Simcenter STAR-CCM Plus. First of all, just the wide range of applications that are now available. For example, you can look at automotive aerodynamics, both steady or transient, aeroacoustics, high fidelity LES, conjugate heat transfer, combustion, and aerospace aerodynamics, to name but a few. And the good news is that the physics and applications that we offer on GPU continue to expand at an exciting rate. So how does GPU performance actually look on a real case? Let's take an automotive aerodynamics example, and in this case, we look at a car with over 300 million cells in the mesh. Running on a single node of 8 A100 GPUs is equivalent to running on around 2,500 CPU cores to achieve the same time to solution. If we translate this into costs on the cloud, then for that same time to solution, you can get your answer for around half the cost. Or to think of this in another way, you can double your simulation throughput for the same cost. Another excellent benefit of GPUs is that their energy consumption is typically much lower than their equivalent CPU-based configuration. This means that you can get your simulation result using less power, which is both a boost for sustainability and for your bottom line. And it's not just about adding more physics models. Since our first release, we've constantly improved the performance on GPU hardware, allowing you to further maximize the benefits that I just mentioned. So are GPUs the silver bullet of CFD simulations, and are CPUs finished with? In short, no. We live in an interesting time of an increasingly heterogeneous hardware landscape. CPUs, ARM, GPUs, and you need to be able to leverage the hardware that best fits your current needs and applications. We are striving to keep results as close as possible across all architectures so that you can be hardware agnostic and use the best possible arrangement for your business case, irrespective of whether using hardware on-premise or a cloud-based solution. So what's on the horizon for Simcenter STAR-CCM Plus and our GPU offering? Well, we're not finished yet. We are committed to continuing to expand the range of available models and applications that can be run natively on GPUs. On top of that, we're always looking for ways to further optimize performance, as well as how to best adapt to the latest trends in GPU hardware, as it also develops side by side. If I was to leave with one takeaway, I would say that the use of GPU hardware on Simcenter STAR-CCM Plus is a step change in allowing rapid and cost-efficient CFD simulation. Ultimately, this means that you will be able to turn today's engineering complexity into a competitive advantage.